and respect tonight. Hundreds attending the wake for Chet Curtis this afternoon. WCVB's legendary news anchor who died last week after a courageous battle with pancreatic cancer. He was just 74 years old. Our Kelly Tuthill is live in Boston right now where fond memories are being recalled tonight, Kel.
We'll add a little lull in the crowd at the funeral home behind me, but believe me, the line's been stretched around the block for much of the day. A who's who of Boston broadcasters, many familiar faces you know from on-camera work, and those who worked behind the lens who loved Chet so much, all coming here today to say goodbye. The line stretched around the building as fellow broadcasters, friends, and viewers came to say goodbye to legendary newsman Chet Curtis.
What you've seen him here, he was in real life back home. You know, he cared for people. He was kind, generous. That's Chet.
Vicki Kennedy sent flowers. Secretary of State John Kerry paid his respects.
Well, he was a class act and a great newsman. And, you know, he really set the standard. He and Natalie together sort of defined the newsroom for Massachusetts for years.
The outpouring of support, so touching to Chet's three grown daughters, mourning the death of their dad at age 74 to pancreatic cancer.
Those three daughters standing there, Lindsay, Dawn, and Dana, have been amazing through all of this, and they're amazing today.
And Chet's cousin tells us he will be going home to Amsterdam, New York for his burial on Tuesday. He'll be buried next to his mother, who died shortly after he was born. Live in Boston's North End, I'm Kelly Tuthill, WCVB News Center 5.
The wake is tonight. Chet's funeral is tomorrow. We will be live streaming the service on WCVB.com and our mobile apps. The funeral begins at 11 a.m.